Well, hi everybody and welcome to another video podcast. Today I wanted to talk about ransomware, which is a type of software that criminals can download onto your devices and encrypt them so that you can't recover them, you can't use your own data, and you can't easily get access to them once again. What do you do about it? How do you recover from it? And how can you prevent it? So ransomware has been around for a few years now, and it increases in complexity all the time. Criminals use it to make money. Simple as that. Like all crime, it's there to make profit. So how do they take control of your devices? Well, some of the easiest ways that this happens is when we click on emails, when we click on a hyperlink, or we click on an attachment in an email that we weren't expecting. This downloads the software, and it might be disguised as a Word document, or a PDF, or a zip file, and that can encrypt your phone, your laptop, your tablet, your servers, the entire network that you're working on. And you can imagine the sort of chaos that this can cause. Criminals during COVID-19 have been targeting hospitals and vaccine development labs with ransomware. Totally inhumane, totally stupid. They shouldn't. Of all the times not to target hospitals and vaccine labs, it's now, but they think they can make money from it. So how do we prevent ourselves from falling victim to this? Well, first off, back up your data. Back up the most important stuff that you can regularly, okay? The things that keep you, your business, your personal life working. Anything that you think is critical to you, to keeping that functionality, make sure you have a backup of it. Ideally, the backup should be offline as well as online. So you have a cloud-based backup as well as a separate hard drive that you've stored things on as well. Because the premise of ransomware is that you're going to try and pay to get access to your data once again. And the way that you don't have to do that is if you've backed it up. You can't be held to ransom for something that you have somewhere else, and you can just start again. So do that, back up online with a cloud-based service and offline in a separate hard drive that isn't connected to the network or the Wi-Fi all the time. That'll really reduce your opportunities of not being able to recover after a ransomware attack. And if you did fall victim to it, you simply reset your device back to factory settings and you start again with the backup data that you already have. And this works across business as well as working for us as individuals as well. So that's how we recover from it, to prevent ourselves falling victim to it. Ideally, be really careful with what you click on emails. If that email doesn't look legitimate, if it feels weird, don't click on anything. Contact the person who sent it first. Not by replying to the email that you've received, but pick up the phone, old school, call them, make sure it was them who sent it. And lastly, if you do find yourselves victim of ransomware, check out Europol's No More Ransom website. I'll put the link in the comments below, and you can try and see if there's a decryption key to get rid of the ransomware that your device has been infected with. But above all, don't pay. Don't pay criminals to try and recover your data. You can't trust them, okay? It's an entirely anonymous transaction. If you have an anonymous email from someone who isn't real name behind it, and they're using Bitcoin or a cryptocurrency, there is no guarantee at all that they're going to give you the key to decrypt your data. So please don't pay them. Worst case, you take a step back, you start again from scratch, but that way you help to keep yourself, your family, your loved ones, your business, your government, your society safe. We're going to do more of these podcasts, these video podcasts. I'd really like to hear from you. What topics would you like us to cover? And we're going to do some in other languages as well, probably Spanish, probably into Russian as well. So really, really keen to hear from you. Put something in the comments. Tell us the topics that you'd like us to address. Doesn't need to be simply cybercrime or money laundering. It could be anything that the UN Office on Drugs and Crime deal with, and we'll be happy to talk about it. Take care. Stay safe. Thanks for watching. Bye.